Hello, welcome to the White Rabbit Antique Shop, where old things turn to new. How may I be of assistance to you today? Okay. Okay, great. So, you were looking for items from the 1950s and the 1960s era. Excellent. Are there any items in particular? Anything that you are collecting right now? Are you looking for any items large in size, small in size, anything that you may be upcycling? I know, a lot of questions. Okay, so you want items small in size, so they fit on top of your vanity. Okay, that makes sense. Okay, so these items are going to be going into your bedroom. Okay. So, are you interested in any clothing items from the 1950s and 60s? Okay. Figurines, pictures, a little bit of everything. Okay, you want me to surprise you? Okay, surprise you I shall. So, yes, I think I got it. I'm going to start off with, I guess some clothing accessories. So, I have three, let's see if you can guess, three pairs of, yes, gloves. When I think of the 1950s, I always think of their beautiful gloves. So, this pair here is sort of a satiny ribbon-like texture. And it's very delicate, it's very light, it's see-through, as you can see, so if you do plan on wearing these, you will see your hands through these, which I think is really cute. There is some nice rouging detailing at the ends of these gloves, which I think is a very charming detail. There is also floral detailing as well. And they're little tiny dots that form these little tiny flowers. So, I love these so much. And these are only $4. So, if you're interested, let me know. What color is your vanity, by the way? Okay, it's white, so anything goes. Okay, so you're not interested in these. That is fine. So, the next pair of gloves are these, also from the 1950s. And these are quite unique due to the color. These are a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful lavender purple. It's a nice brighter color, but not too bright. But I think it would really pop on your vanity and definitely be a nice statement piece. These have some really pretty details as well. So here we have these little bows at the end of these gloves, and this stitching here that makes the ribbon to the bow. And as you can see, the 1950s women had very slender hands, very small petite hands. These are a little thicker in texture than the first pair of gloves that I showed you. The fabric of these are very, very soft. It almost feels like a satin cotton blend or just a very well-made polyester. So, I love this stitching detail right here by the thumb. Very cute. So they're simple, but they still make a nice statement as well. If you're going for the 50s theme, are you interested in these? These are $8. Yes. Great. So I'm just going to input this into my computer. AC02. Great. I do have one more pair of gloves. These are also really, really beautiful. A nice sky blue. And these are longer than the other two that I showed you. Very, very stretchy. Stretchier than the other two as well. And such beautiful stitching. The details on here are just incredible. A nice floral design. The stitching kind of shines when the light hits it. And again, for being from the 1950s, it is in really good condition. There's no stains. Very, very nice. And this one is $8 as well. Are you interested in these? Yes? Okay. So let me input this as well. AC225HB. Okay. Great. So let's see what else we have here. This is a hat. This has to be one of my favorite pieces that I'm going to be showing you today. This is a white ribbon hat from the 1950s. And I guess this would be more of a cream color, in my opinion. This is stretchy, so if you do feel like wearing it, you can. And it makes amazing sounds. The gloves and the hats were just impeccable in the 1950s and 1960s. Now, since this isn't a hard hat, it's not going to stay put on top of your vanity. So my suggestion, if you're interested in this piece, is to find yourself like a jewelry box and just place it on top of the jewelry box and it will sit really nice and pretty. You can also stuff it with newspaper, whatever you feel is best. But yes, this is also a really great quality. And I can only imagine the time this took to make this piece. It's really quite intricate. It's simple, but intricate. But this is the hat inside out, so you can see there's no rips or tears. There's some feathers from my other hats. Are you interested in this hat? Do you want to see other hats? Do you like this one? Would you like to see any other ones? No? Okay. So, a yes for this. This is $18. Okay. So let me just input this as well. See. Excellent. Okay. So the next thing, let's switch it up a little bit. I thought this would look so cute. Now, this is a vintage watering can from the 1960s. And as you can see, it has some beautiful colors. We have 3 bouquets of flowers. We have an orange bouquet of flowers. We have a yellow bouquet of flowers. And we also have a blue bouquet of flowers. And there is a really nice gold trim at the bottom and at the top. And this, yes, it still works. So, if you would like to use this for the intended use, you can. You can water your plants and your flowers. Some people actually removed this top here, and they put flowers in here, and they just use it as a vase. Some people use this as their soap dispenser. I've seen a lot of people do that. And that's also a really cute idea. But since you're looking for pieces for your vanity, this just makes a really cute decor piece. Now you can put this on your windowsill in your bedroom if you have a thick enough windowsill. The options are endless with this piece, and this piece is $18, in case you're interested. Yeah, it's gorgeous. So that's a yes. Awesome. Let me jot this down. AC09. Excellent. So just put that onto the side. And the next piece, let's see. I have this cute little coin purse. It is made out of real leather. It has this fleur-de-lis emblem here in gold. A nice cute little detail. This little coin purse, it has been well loved, I must say. That is the inside of the coin purse. It smells like leather. It's a nice, beautiful tan brown. And this one is from the 1950s as well. And this is only $5 in case you're interested. Yeah, it's still in good condition in case you did want to use it. Now, there's no holes or anything. The stitching is still really good. You'll pass on it? Okay, so put that off to the side. The next thing that I thought was super adorable and that you might like is this. This is a mirror. A little pocket mirror from the 1960s, and it has this little Victorian lady, and I would say this is in a shape of a fan. It could be a seashell. I know seashells were very in, but I do believe that this is a fan, but the lady on the mirror is just beautiful, and I don't want to blind you, but the mirror does work. There's no cracks or anything like that. This is a plasticky material. I don't believe this is acrylic. So this is $5. Yeah, it's beautiful, beautiful. I love the coloring on this. You're interested in it? So you'll take it. Okay, great. Let's see. AC0. Okay, I'm so happy you're liking some of these items. So the next items that I want to share with you are these beautiful, beautiful handkerchiefs, or hankies as they used to call them. And we have this one here. This one is a floral print. I chose this one because of the beautiful colors. I think you'll like this one because it matches the purple lavender gloves. It's just beautiful. It has lavender, it has turquoise, it has this bright, like, mustardy yellow. Yeah, I can open it up for you so you can see. It's a nice, good size. It's like a nice muslin cloth, like gauzy sort of material. Very light. You like it? Awesome. So this is $250. Okay. Let's see. Excellent. So put that off to the side. I have this one here. This one is a little more on the pricier side. This one's actually from the 1940s, but I did want to throw it in here because it's quite a rare find, and it's in such good condition, and I thought you would like it because of all the details. But this one has some beautiful, beautiful lacing, and it has this embroidery here with these flowers, some beautiful yellow flowers. Yes, I'll open it up for you as well. So there it is. So all of the embroidery and the lacing is on one corner, same material as the last one. But yes, this is a little more on the pricier side, due to it being a little older, and it's just an amazing condition. But yeah, it is $10. Yes, awesome. Okay, AC33. Great. So this next one is also from the 1940s as well. And it's a different color. That's why I decided to choose it, just in case. But this is a really nice light tannish color. And it has some lacing, some like doily lacing all throughout, in beautiful colors of coral, cream, and green. I just thought it was gorgeous. It has these little cutouts that make a square. And it has a sticker here that says, "Warranted all linen." So, beautiful piece from the 1940s. I know that this color may not be for everyone, but it's very unique. You'll pass on it. Okay. Not your colors. I totally, totally understand. This next hanky is so cute and so unique. It is a beautiful, beautiful stitching of California. And we have Yosemite, Eureka, Sacramento, Berkeley, San Francisco, Catalina, San Diego, Los Angeles, Hollywood, Palm Springs, Bakersfield. And yeah, I just think it's perfection the way it has been stitched. This is from 1950s. I'll open it up for you as well. So that's what it looks like. It's a really, really nice piece. If you're a fan of California or a fan of traveling, this is awesome. You'll pass on it. Okay. This next one doesn't have any lacing or anything like that. However, the colors are beautiful. This one is also from the 1950s, and it's a red hanky with beautiful, beautiful blue flowers. So that's what this one looks like. It's a little bigger than the other ones, but I love the colors to this. Very, very bright, very, very fun. So, nice pop of red and green and yellow and blue. If you're into florals, this would be perfect. You like this one? Awesome. So this one is $2. Okay. Zero. The next one, I have this one in a baggie. This is actually a child hanky, but I have to show you this one. Now, can you tell me the theme of this one? Yes, Alice in Wonderland. In which this antique shop is named after. Here sits two Alices and they're leaning on a mushroom. They could possibly be sitting on the mushroom, not quite sure, but they're drinking something, which is very Alice. And it has this beautiful, beautiful Alice blue, I would say. And it has these flowers here, and yeah, it is much smaller than a regular handkerchief, just to show you the difference. This is a regular hanky, and this would be a child hanky. So, as you can see, much smaller, but so cute, and this hanky is definitely for someone who is a child at heart, loves whimsical things. Yeah, it's so cute. You love it? Oh, you love Alice in Wonderland? Yes, my kind of person. This is $5. Are you still interested? Yes, okay, great. I'll just put it back in the bag. Very small and delicate piece. And just input this. So that was $5. I do have another Alice piece, actually. We have a lot of Alice pieces around our shop, but this just came in, and I think it's adorable. It is a vintage doll of Alice, and her face is made out of porcelain, as well as her tiny little hands, and her legs and feet and shoes are also porcelain. So, her body is squishy though, but the rest of her body is very fragile. So I wouldn't really consider this a toy for a child, in case they're prone to throw their toys around. But it's really cute to collect a piece if you love Alice in Wonderland. She has her little red bow here, and her beautiful blonde locks. Does have a marking on her cheek, but I can get some solution to wash that off without messing up her paint. It also comes with her little book. So this is from the company Russ Berry and Company Inc. from Oakland, New Jersey. She has her little apron, her blue little dress, her black little flats, and her cute little face. You like it? Awesome. This is actually $25, which I know may be a little expensive, but since you purchasing so many of her items today, I will give you this for just $5. Sounds good? Okay. Excellent. So, I just have a few extra things. The next item, I do have another clothing accessory that I think you will fall in love. This particular item comes from the 60s. This is actually in its original packaging. This is a humongous black bow. And this is from 1964 to be exact. This is the Solo On Clip Fashion Bow, and it was just $1 in its time. And as you can see, it has this little ring here, which I assume was hooked onto a display. And that's how they were displayed, just hanging on like a hook. And, of course, whoever purchases this can open it up, but I don't recommend. I kind of like the fact that it's still in its original packaging, but to each their own. I mean, if someone wants to rock this, that would be awesome as well. And you can see the little pictures of how the women in the 60s wore them, and how the woman in the 60s looked. I love that. It's funny how fashion kind of cycles, because I can totally see Lady Gaga wearing this. Like, this gives me Lady Gaga vibes. I guess Lady Gaga a couple years back, but still so cute. Maybe Ariana Grande would rock this too. So, So, of course, since it's in its original packaging, it is $10 if you're interested. Yes. Okay, awesome. This next piece, I'm not sure if you will fall in love with, but just hear me out. It's not exactly part of your era, but I do have an idea for it. So, here it is here. This is definitely more the Edwardian style. It's more of the 1920s era, so not exactly what you're looking for. However, I was thinking that you could paint the actual frame a white or like a chalk paint, right? And you can kind of distress it a little bit. You can take out this picture because it is more of the 1920s style and put a 1950s or 1960s vintage photo in here. And I think it would just look beautiful. Now it is surrounded by this red velvet. So I don't know if you'll like the red velvet. And there's really nothing you could do about that. However, I think it still would be really, really pretty if you just changed up the gold trim a little bit. I think you would really like it. Now, this is a wall hanging. But I do have this piece here. Now, I will have to say this isn't an actual antique. This is more of like a mock antique. And I do offer these things, you know, for those who can't afford paying a huge price for like an antique frame. Because they can get very, very pricey. So, that's just an option. This, however, is an antique. And it's what I think would go perfectly with this frame. This is actually metal. It's very heavy. This is heavy too, but it's more of like a plaster heavy. And this is like a true metal heavy. So, I think that it would look beautiful. And of course, you could paint this as well. A white or whichever color you prefer, but they are sold separately, and this is $14.95, true vintage, and this one here is $15.95. If this was the real deal, this would be up in the 200s, so just for comparison. So, you like my idea? Excellent. Okay, so I was thinking that I would show you some vintage photos if you're interested. Let me just jot these down. So, input them, I should say. 6. Awesome. And then let me input this as well. Done. So I'm just going to show you a couple of vintage pictures. I have a couple that I think you'll really like. So this here is a picture of 4 ladies. Not sure if they're friends, maybe nurses, maybe they work together. I just loved it. I love their attire. It definitely screams 50s and 60s to me. And that's only 5 cents, so that's pretty good. We have this little girl, and I love her outfit. She has a gorgeous dress on with a hat and a purse. And look at her shoes. So cute. And this is 5 cents. I can't really tell if she's happy to be in this picture. But yeah, she has gloves on too. She's all decked out. Maybe ready to go to church. Who knows? You're interested in this one? We have this one here with 3 children, a young girl and 2 young boys. They are sitting in front of their steps, I presume. Okay. Let's see. There's this one here. These look like the same ladies that I showed you in the first picture, and they're all laughing and having a grand old time. And I thought that this picture captured a lovely moment. You like this one? This one is 5 cents as well. This next one is a picture of a lovely family. We see the mother there with all of her children. She has 4 girls. And they're all just gorgeous. I love how little girls always had like little purses with them. You like this one? This one is also 5 cents. In case you're a doggy lover, you're more of a cat lover. We have this one of a little girl. It looks like she's making prayer hands. I love her curls. You like this one? Okay, 5 cents. We have a picture of a baby, like a newborn. This is from the 1940s. This one's a little more pricier. It's 35 cents. Not super pricey, but it's not 5 cents. Yeah, it looks like he is laying on his belly on like a hospital baby cot. So that's a yes. Okay. Excellent. We have this lady here, and it looks like she's winking, and I just loved everything about it, like her house and how it was decorated. I don't know what she's holding. It could be like a hat box or a hat. I'm not quite sure, but this picture is 35 cents, and it's from the 1950s. This vintage picture of elephants. I don't know, I'm a fan of vintage pictures of animals. This is another picture of a baby. It actually has a name, and his name was Alan, A-L-A-N, from the 40s, 35 cents. This larger picture of a young man and 2 young women, and they're all dressed very dapper and gorgeous. And this is 35 cents from the 1950s. You like? Okay. Excellent. This one is probably one of my favorites. It's what looks like 3 children in a car, and they're like making faces, and 2 are making bubbles, bubble gum. And everything. This one is 35 cents and it's from the 1940s. Yeah, you want to take another look? Yeah, okay. This next one is of a lady. I loved the way that she's posed. I loved her outfit. And this is from the 1940s. And this one is 35 cents. No. Okay. Then we have this one here. This is actually a postcard from the 1940s. And I just loved the way that he looked. He just looks so cool. And I don't know if he graduated high school or what's going on, but he has some sort of certificate, diploma. Maybe this is a high school photo. I'm not sure. But this is 35 cents. Yeah. Excellent. And we have these three children having fun at the beach. And this one is 5 cents. No. Okay. They picked out some great photos though, I must say. I do have some two larger photos that I thought you might like. I don't have a lot of larger photos from the 1950s and 1960s. However, I do have these two beautiful photos from the 1920s. And including, well, this one is including the actual vintage frame, and it has this album here, but this one is from the 1920s, like I said, and it's $8, but this girl is so beautiful, and I love the 1920s and the Great Gatsby era, but this is her. And she's just the epitome of elegance and beauty. And I just adore it. I adore her so much. I love her hair and her pearls and her little feather details on her dress. It could be a scarf, I'm not sure. But it says her name is Mildred. Mildred Lovingly. Her name is just, I love it. So, that is Mildred Lovingly. And she is lovely. And this is actually a picture from Boston. So, Mildred was from Boston. Do you like her? You love her. Awesome. I thought that you would. I thought that you would. So, let me see. A good price for a 1920s photo. $8. Really good. So, the last one. And this is a male. I wasn't sure if you would like this one. But this is like a plaque. And, this young gentleman is from Vermont, Montpelier, Vermont, and it just says Harlow. I don't know if that's the company who took this photo, but this is the young man, and I just think that he looks so cool. I just wonder, like, everything about. Is he a doctor, a scientist, a writer? I just think he has an amazing face. Was he Jack the Ripper? Just kidding. But yeah, I love it. And this one is $5. You'll pass. Okay. Thank you so much for your business today and for deciding to shop at the White Rabbit Antique Shop, where all things turn into new. And I would love doing business with you again. It was my pleasure selecting all of these items for you. And I have personally wrapped everything in bubble wrap, and I have placed them in a bag for you right over there. You definitely can continue to browse around and see if there's anything else that catches your eye. And I have your receipts here. Do not want to forget that. One receipt. Two receipt. Three receipt. Four receipt. And five. Yes, I actually write down everything. I do things old school around here. So, until we meet again.